Hello, movie buffs. Welcome back to another episode of Decrypting Movies. You're watching MW. I'm MaddiE Dawson. We are going to review another round in this episode. So, let's get to it. Alright, so it's been a long time since we had done a Decrypting Movies episode, so we'll get into it. This is my blog on another round. As you can see, it's a Danish film. The original name of the film is Druk, and it's available on Amazon Prime, and it's 1 hour 57 minutes in length. So this blog will not reveal any plot points or spoilers, so you can read the blog and decide whether to watch the movie or not. My verdict is cheers, because I'll come to it. And yeah, IMDB rating 7.8. This film has won the Oscar for the International Best Feature Film in 2021, I guess. Yeah. Before we start the episode, we'll watch the trailer.
Det er godt det her.
Ja, det er sgu
sådan,
du er så fornuftig.
Men spørgsmålet er, hvad der i virkeligheden er fornuftigt. Der findes en norsk filosof, han mener, at mennesker er født med en halv promille for lidt.
Altså jeg må sige, jeg kunne da godt sådan bruge en halv promille sådan på daglig basis for at få lidt mere selvtillid.
Det har vi da alle sammen brug for. Det har du da også brug for.
Jeg synes, det er spændende.
Det gør jeg også.
Så det er det, vi gør.
Afhandling. Daglig indtagelse af alkohol.
Ja.
Tilstrækning. Konstant niveau. På en halv promille. Med henblik på indsamling af evidens,
ja,
psykologiske og psykoretoriske følgevirkninger samt undersøgelse af forøget social og faglig udvikling.
Det er kun i arbejdstiden, vi drikker, ikke?
Men det er jo ligesom Hemingway. Vi drikker ikke efter 8 og ikke weekend.
Er I klar?
Ja!
Ja!
Så vi skifter gear.
It's okay. It's okay.
Er I fuld? Nej, det er ikke. Forklar dig for børnene, hvad som er hent.
Jeg bliver lidt fuld i morgen.
Jeg hele tiden synes, det var fint, at I eksperimenterede alt muligt, men det her, det er ordentligt.
Jeg går ikke ud fra, at der er nogen her, der har et problem, jeg skal vide noget om.
Yeah, you can get to know why I had my verdict was cheers, because the whole movie is about drinks. Yeah, we'll come back to the verdict. So the story is about a college professor. He's teaching history in a college, high school college. So he's having a worst time of his life. So he's having problems with his wife. Things are not good as family, and even in the class, he's getting negative reviews from the students that he's not able to teach the subject properly. So that's where the movie starts. Our protagonist, the professor, is having a very bad time at his life, and incidentally, his friend's birthday comes in place, and they are having this drinks party in a elite restaurant, and there they are talking about the philosophy behind drinks, and all the friends are college professors. So one of them is a psychology professor, and he says that humans are born with, as you can see, 0.05% lack of alcohol. So this is the inciting instance where the story kickstarts, and the protagonist decides that he'll experiment this methodology. he thinks that, okay, let me try that. So they start taking alcohol, in a measured level every day and see how they are improving in each areas they do. So one of them is the protagonist is a history professor, the other guy is a psychology professor, and there's a football coach, and there's music artist. So he teaches music in the same school. So everybody is experimenting this philosophy of having 0.5% alcohol and experimenting on lives in day-to-day basis. So that's what they do. Basically, it's a drama film, but the screenplay is presented in an experimental manner. As you can see, they try out this and they even try to create a report. So after some point of time, it becomes too much. One of them gets addicted, and it does not end up well for that particular character. So this is the whole story. For all the other three characters, it turns out very well, especially for our protagonist. Things are back on track. He's becoming a favorite teacher among the students because he's innovative in his methods of teaching. And even the musical teacher, as well as the psychology professor, is having good reviews from students. He's able to connect with students. So all of them are having a good improvement in their lives after this experiment. But one, the football coach gets addicted to alcohol, and he gets even gets caught up in the school, college, that there's a professor who comes to college drunk. So he gets expelled, and eventually he dies. So that is a spoiler, anyhow. So the reason the movie is great is simply because of the screenplay. You see that it's a drama genre, but as the movie progresses, you are very engrossed with it, because it's like something they are doing. You do not know what is going to happen next, and you can only predict what's going to happen. But then something will happen that will completely bemuse you, and it's very funny. It's a dark comedy, so it's a very good movie. You can see the graph of the characters from point zero to the point end, and how they improve over the course of the movie. You get connected with each and every character, the four major characters. And obviously, as you can see, if you do not know the protagonist, he is one of the famous villains of James Bond films, Mads Mikkelsen. And it is a Danish film. I watched it in the Danish language with subtitles, so I would recommend the same to you, because you can see the and experience it in its original context. And this is about the story. And coming to the narration, it's in the third person perspective, and you see the lives of four characters and their families. One guy is just living with his dog, and he's the football coach who gets who dies at the end. And the other four characters are having family, so how they come into the picture, and how they contribute to these four characters' daily life. So all that matters. It has been presented very well. There is a scene where you see that our protagonist, Mads Mikkelsen, the lead character, is having a good time with the family after he's improved his life with this alcohol intake, measured alcohol intake. And it's presented in an artistic manner with lots of musical dimension, because you have very good music now and then that elevates the film to a different level. And that is also another good aspect that compels you to watch this movie. It's a very entertaining movie, that is for sure. I sincerely believe that anyone who watches this movie will be overjoyed. And whoever is a fan of drinks will definitely enjoy this movie, because this movie encourages you to drink. So that is a very popular motto that everybody would love, and that itself would be sufficient to make you watch this movie, I guess. Overall, it's a very technically and clinically made film. I didn't find any fault. There are obviously boring moments, because the movie kickstarts in a way. We are seeing the monotonous life of the protagonist, so you get empathetic towards the lead character the very first scene, because there is one scene where this parent teacher meeting especially called in for the professor, which is who's our protagonist, and they complain that my children are saying that my kids are saying that you are not fit enough to teach the history subject. So that's how the movie starts. We get pity because watching such a guy who's very innocent and very naive, he's not able to perform in his life, and then the inciting incident kicks in. They try out this alcohol, measured alcohol intake, and see their lives improved. It works out brilliantly for the protagonist. He's getting famous among the students. He's winning back their trust, and everybody. He's teaching becomes innovative. There's a lot of things in the movie. So Druk, another round, is one good movie that you shouldn't miss out, and it's available on Amazon Prime. Do watch it if you haven't, and I hope you enjoyed this episode of Decrypting Movies. I'll catch up in another episode. Until then, it's Maddie Dawson, you're watching MWM. Subscribe to my channel. Until next episode, it's bye bye from Maddie.